In the last several years, there has been a huge increase in the number of phone apps designed to help people track their menstrual cycles. Many of these claim that they will shorten the time that it takes for you to become pregnant. Here on Infertility TV, we like to see scientific proof before we make recommendations. So, is there any science behind these claims? Stay tuned and find out. When a person is trying to become pregnant, the highest chance for success is during the fertile window. This is the roughly 5-day period of time ending on the day of ovulation. People who have intercourse during the fertile window are going to have a higher chance for conception. How can you tell when you are in your fertile window? There are a number of indicators, including methods like home ovulation tests, and monitoring your cervical mucus. Check out this playlist for information about those methods. Many phone apps which track a person's periods claim to be able to predict a person's fertile window and improve their chance for conceiving. There hasn't been much scientific study to back up these claims. Recently, researchers conducted a study in people who were trying to conceive called the Pregnancy Study Online, or PRESTO. Female participants completed an online questionnaire with items on demographics, behaviors, reproductive and medical histories, and medication use. They then completed follow-up questionnaires every 8 weeks or until reported conception. In the absence of a pregnancy, patients were followed for up to a year. Fertility treatment was not allowed during the study. In this part of the PRESTO study, they looked at people who were using fertility apps either with or without other ovulation indicators. People in this study used over 120 different phone apps. 5 apps were designated as being ones the authors thought were more likely to be effective. They referred to these as selected apps. For the analysis, people were divided into the following groups. Number 1, no use of any apps or any fertility indicators like an ovulation predictor test. Group 2, was use of fertility apps without any fertility indicators. And group 3, use of fertility apps along with a fertility indicator. They also analyzed success using their selected apps versus all of the other phone apps. Ultimately, they were able to study over 8,000 people trying to conceive. The chance for a pregnancy in a given month was highest for the group that used a phone app and a fertility indicator like an ovulation predictor test or cervical mucus. This group was about 23% more likely to conceive compared to the group who didn't use any method to improve their chances. The group that used an app alone had a 17% better chance for a pregnancy each month. This was better than doing nothing, but not as good as using an app combined with a fertility indicator. Interestingly, the group that used the selected apps, the ones that the authors thought would work best, actually did not work as well as the other non-selected apps. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. The use of phone apps to track fertility seems to improve the chance for a pregnancy each month by a small amount. Combining an app with a method to detect ovulation worked better than using an app alone. Overall, there wasn't one app that worked significantly better than another. One other issue to be aware of when using these apps: privacy. If you live in a state in which abortions are being severely limited or banned, there is a very real concern that people who have an abortion or assist someone to have an abortion will be criminally charged or face lawsuits. Authorities in those states can and will obtain your private fertility information and can use it to prosecute you. This has already happened. Last year, a popular tracking app was found to be selling personal information from millions of users to third parties, even though they claimed to protect that information. Last month, police in Nebraska used social media posts to arrest a mom who helped her underage daughter get an abortion. If you are going to use these fertility tracking apps, you need to be aware of these risks. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.